亲爱的旅行者们，大家好，我是你们老朋友大伟哥。本次的前瞻特别节目依旧是由我来担任节目的主持人。不知不觉间啊，原神也陪着大家走过了一段漫长的时光。从蒙德到枫丹，这一路以来啊，我们不仅经历了许多精彩的冒险故事，也邂逅了形形色色的角色伙伴。再过不久，原神也将迎来公测3周年的日子了。为此，我们项目组同学也准备了丰富多彩的游戏内容和活动情报，呈现给每一位旅行者。希望旅行者们无论是在游戏内还是游戏外，都能够感受到3周年的节日氛围。那么事不宜迟，先让我们一起来观赏版本 PV， 看看新版本啊会给我们带来哪些精彩的内容吧。
Actually in jail. What?
The fortress of Meripede may seem like a prison, but it should in fact be regarded as a gathering place for exiles. I will arrange false charges against you so that you may secretly investigate inside the fortress.
The truth is, this place has a lot of hidden rules.
All of our informants, including the ones that had infiltrated the guards, suddenly vanished.
Something bad will happen during lunch on the third day.
A mysterious box, a bottle of crimson liquid.
Ooh.
So, you know those pipes that make strange sounds? Don't ever, ever go near them at night.
Sooner or later, all will pay the price for their arrogance.
His voice is cool.
This could get a little chilly.
Time's up. Negotiations have broken down. Please leave, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay.
If Risley does have a plan, what could it be?
Risley?
After being away from the sunlight for so long, even the terrifying depths of the sea start to feel like home.
I have to...
Have we entered into the next stage of the prophecy?
Is that?
And now, another catastrophe will soon be upon us. I mourn this turn of events.
Bro, the music! Oh my lord.
I find it difficult to express my emotions because I cannot fully understand myself.
I'm confident that we'll find the meaning of our existence one day.
Rumors saying that you were born from calamity. You inherently bring danger to those around you.
Why should we trust this species from who knows where anyway?
Melusines can't be trusted! That goes for Nervalette too!
There's only one thought on my mind. Only through bloodshed can their debt be repaid.
Risley, where did you take my siblings?
Even if the truth may not be pleasant,
since they have no way to dispose of the leftover remains, they have ways to transform them into other forms and keep them in the fortress forever.
It beggars belief just how carefree you have been. From the very beginning, you, the god Fossilor, have failed to take action.
Whose voice is that?
What are you trying to do? Please,
I saw the
shit.
Oh my god.
I'm begging you.
Is this what justice means to you? Answer me, Nervalette!
You will see much in the human world, from the delightful to the depressing. And one day, when you have dwelt among humanity long enough, you will be placed to bring judgment over all as a spokesperson for Fontaine's past.
It is unnecessary to hold me in such high regard.
Who was that? Oh my god. But that looks so good.
旅行者们，欢迎回来。 不知道有没有和我一样的旅行者，每次看完新版本的 PV 啊，都会对其中出现的角色和故事非常的好奇。所以今天啊，我也依旧是邀请了项目组的小伙伴，我们的战斗设计师叶黑，来给我们介绍新版本中的相关剧情以及角色的情报。
非常感谢大伟哥的邀请，旅行者们大家好，这次会由我来向各位旅行者介绍剧情和角色的相关内容。
哎，欢迎欢迎。哎，自从做完这个 4.0 的模式任务以后啊，我一直想知道之后的发展。趁着这次机会啊，叶黑啊，先和我们聊聊 4.1 版本的模式任务好了。
好，先问一下大伟哥，还记得 4.0 相关的版本剧情吗？
有印象，不过还是叶黑啊，帮我们简单回顾一下吧。
Plot summary chat。
我们初到枫丹时，就协助林尼、纳维亚他们解决了几宗案件，但其实最后都汇聚到了一个案件上，也就是
少女连环失踪案。
而且在此期间，鱼人众的执行官公子还有于不明的原因被审判送进了梅洛彼得堡。
没错，看到这里的时候我就在想啊，被审判的可是鱼人众的执行官啊，怎么看也不是一件小事。鱼人众应该不会坐视不管吧，是不是会有新的执行官因此登场呢？
大伟哥很敏锐啊。没错，在 4.1 版本中，故乡为枫丹的执行官仆人，为了处理这起外交事件，也前来与鬼神弗林娜以及最高审判官纳维莱
特会面。Why is she sitting with them？
这场面想想就很精彩。
那是必然的，而且仆人提出的几个方案其实都被婉拒了。
这么一听啊，感觉火药味很浓啊。
是有那么一点，不过最终纳维莱特还是答应派人前去梅洛彼得堡确认公子的情况，这才暂且压下了这股火药味。
我猜猜，所以这个任务就落到了我们旅行者的肩上，是吧？
没错，为了让我们顺利融入梅洛彼得堡，贴心的纳维莱特先生给我们安排了一个小小的罪名。哦对，这里就得简单提一下梅洛彼得堡的设定，因为梅洛彼得堡并不是简单枫丹监狱这一个概念，它名义上并不隶属于枫丹的司法体系，一直都是以自治的形式而存在。所以纳维莱特才需要让我们伪装成囚犯下去调查。
Oh, look at us getting mugshots。
的任务啊，看上去还挺新鲜的。
在 4.1 版本中呢，枫丹的魔神任务第三幕向深水中的晨星，和第四幕御史胎动的终焉之刻。
Cataclysm's quickening。
需要在梅洛彼得堡暗中调查一系列的事件，以及追寻公子的行踪。值得一提的是，这个过程中旅行者会得到一些老朋友的帮助，也会遇到一些新的面孔，比如梅洛彼得堡的公爵莱欧斯利以及护士长西格文，展开一系列的冒险故事。各位旅行者们请敬请期待呀。
看起来啊，四点一版本的故事重心都是在梅洛彼得堡呀。旅行者啊，如果想要在这里调查，我猜一定会与梅洛彼得堡的最高负责人莱欧斯利进行一番斗智斗勇。叶黑啊，不妨具体为我们介绍一下这位公爵呢？
作为梅洛彼得堡的管理人，莱欧斯利确实很有一些手段，既能照顾得到弱势的群体，也能镇得住强势的恶棍。在他上位后，实施了一系列的改革，让梅洛彼得堡运作得焕然一新。也正是因为如此，梅洛彼得堡并不是像大家所想的那样如监狱一般，甚至有一些刑满释放的罪人都不愿意离开了。
听你这么一说啊，这位公爵可真是不得了啊。不过啊，梅洛彼得堡作为全枫丹罪人的流放地啊，只有高超的管理手腕，我感觉可能不够，想必他也拥有令人信服的实力吧。
没错，作为犯人的流放聚集地，梅洛彼得堡多多少少总会有一些不服从管理的犯人，这时候道理讲不通，就只能通过其他方法以理服人了。而莱欧斯利自然也不缺乏这方面的实力，由于莱欧斯利之前当过地下拳手，因此拥有高超的战斗技巧。
这种战斗方式啊，倒也确实符合我对他的想象，在这种情势复杂的地方，拳头有时候才是硬道理嘛。
搏击意味着力量的碰撞，但也常有故意卖弄破绽给对方，然后猛然回击的表现。作为一个冰元素的法器使用者，莱欧斯利的攻击和重击都能造成冰元素的伤害。
Damn like Hazel, one but simple.
同时损失生命值，不过不用担心，这些损失的生命值正是他用来引
诱对手进攻
和抓住观众眼球的关键。在莱欧斯利的生命值较低时，他的重击则会被大幅的强化，并在命中敌人后大量恢复自身的生命值。
看完他的技能啊，我能够感受到他独特的战斗方式了。占据优势时对敌人穷追猛打，然后故意卖出自己的破绽，让敌人觉得有机可乘，之后啊，在危机时一发逆转玩弄敌人。
大卫哥的描述可真是生动形象啊，他的战斗方式与他的处事风格可谓十分的相似。
Yep, first Ice Catalyst.
非常擅长调动资源，在合成武器突破术材时，莱欧斯利
We finally have a Cryo Catalyst user.
这位公爵大人可真是多才多艺啊，管理、战斗样样精通，真是太厉害了。
没错，不过虽然莱欧斯利做事很有一套手段，但梅洛彼得堡毕竟是建立在枫丹的水下，常年见不到阳光，在监狱的阴暗角落里依然会有邪恶在滋生。在 4.1 版本中，莱欧斯利的传说任务守御犬之章也将上线。
We have so much, right?
可以在任务中进行了解。
A word of advice, don't break the law. Is there anything else? Yeah, seriously, don't break the law.
His voice actor is really good.
A moment, please.Have a safe trip. Perhaps we could take a walk by a riverbank or somewhere similarly fluvial. Silence! Be sanctified.
He's so pretty. Just elegance.
4.1 版本上线的另一位角色，则是枫丹的最高审判官纳维莱特。在 4.0 版本中，我们就已经和他打过交道了。相信大伟哥一定不会陌生吧？
嗯，我对纳维莱特印象非常深刻。他在审判时啊，公正无私，而且实力非常强大。给人一种
unfathomable aura.
其实枫丹的很多人对于拉维莱特的形象认知都是这样的，因此都对他十分的敬畏。拉维莱特身为枫丹的最高审判官，主持着枫丹关于正义的审判体系，需要维持公正的原则。不仅是在法庭之上，在日常的生活中，他也会时刻注意公众的影响，比如他会尽量避免与他人有私交，以及有流程外的协作，防止被人怀疑司法体系的不公。
他对自己的要求啊，可真严格啊，不愧是最高审判官，严于律己啊。
没错，不过这位最高审判官也没大家想象的那么严肃罢了，他其实也是有自己的爱好和生活的，比如拉维莱特就有一个品水的爱好。虽然他离开枫丹的次数屈指可数，但是他已经品尝过来自世界各地的名泉了，都是从外地送过来的。
Look at him drinking.
他还会发表自己对各地
饮用水的评价。It's too elegant.
比如，他觉得蒙德的水清廉，璃月的水回味悠长。
That's his idol, I guess.
我一直以为啊，只有茶可以这么品啊，想不到只是普通的水啊，纳维莱特都能品出那么多花样。
Wow, he can differentiate the features in water.
纳维莱特既有对公的一面，其实也有对私的一面。他十分喜爱美露星，认为他们是一个善良美丽的种族。拉维莱特甚至在枫丹法规中加入了一条巧妙的法律，对美露星的称呼必须使用人格意味的他，而不能用他。
没想到这位最高审判官还有这样的一面。不过美露星确实十分可爱，我十分理解他的行为。
其实还有一支直接隶属于最高审判官的特别刑侦机构——烛影庭，绝大多数雇员都是由美露星组成的。这倒不是因为纳维莱特偏心，因为美露星们的特殊视觉。能够看到人类难以观察到的东西，能帮助纳维莱特收集各种证据进行审判。但这个特点让在烛影庭里工作的美露星们很容易受到犯罪分子的威胁。
Oh, no.
纳维莱特自然也不会对这种情况坐视不管。
He saves them.
在 4.1 版本中，旅行者还可以通过体验纳维莱特的传说任务《潮涌之章》，了解更多关于他的故事。
哦，纳维莱特亲自出马，那这群犯罪分子可以有苦头吃了。在4.0版本中啊，他的实力可给我留下了深刻的印象。
没错，纳维莱特虽然平时并不会轻易的出手，但他过人的实力是毋庸置疑的，惹恼他绝对不是一个明智的选择。纳维莱特的攻击方式是围绕重击展开的，在一段时间的蓄力后，纳维莱特的攻击将持续消耗生命值，并释放汹涌的洪流，持续对前方直线区域内的敌人造成水元素范围伤害。纳维莱特当前的生命值越高，重击造成的伤害也就越高，而他的元素战技 元素爆发则可以生成一种叫做元水之滴的球体，终极在蓄力时则会自动吸收前方区域内的元水之滴，恢复它的生命值，并缩短蓄力所需的时间。
Look at the glowing stuff at the back though. Yeah, that's his charge today.
角色进行水下冲刺的移动速度也会得到提
升。 We can swim faster with it.
纳瓦雷特攻击方式、还真是简明直观，凌厉但又不失优雅。那么两位新角色的情况我们也都初步了解了，我们接下来再为大家介绍一下新版本的活动起源安排吧。
Watch reruns.
相信肯定很多旅行者已经等候多时了。
好呀，在 4.1 版本中，纳维莱特与胡塔将会在第一期活动起源中出现，并提升获取概率。在第二期活动起源中，除了新朋友莱欧斯利外，我们的老朋友温迪也将迎来复刻，并获得概率 up。 值得一提的是，胡桃和温迪也会在这个版本的活动中与大家见面了。更多信息也会由我的同事稍后为大家揭晓。
Hutao and Wendy will be making an appearance in the event，
加入到武器活动起源中。
OK，
感谢夜黑。那么在给大家带来新伙伴的信息之后呢，还请大家休息片刻，看一下第一则兑换码。之后啊，我们还会给大家带来新版本的场景地图情报，精彩继续哦。
New map, chat new area as well. Let's write it down. No. The music is so pretty. FB8. They're giving us 4 minutes to write down the code. Yeah. Damn, chat, we should go to New York Comic Con. Yeah, let's go to NYC. I feel the same. This time I used my brain chat. I opened the Hoyo like redeem page on my phone. And I've redeemed it already. So many voices in that trailer chat. I have a feeling, I don't know why, I feel like at the end we were hearing Ryan Daughter. Anniversary.
Happy anniversary, Genshin Impact. Erica Harlicker, voice of Venti here, wishing you a happy anniversary. Me and a few of my fellow voice actors have decided to celebrate by sharing some Genshin-inspired treats. I'll be making a Mondstadt-inspired twist on an autumn classic, an apple cider float. The best part about this recipe is that it doesn't need any fancy kitchen gadgets, so just get rid of those. All you need is a good saucepan and the ingredients listed here. If you're a younger traveler, make sure there's an adult
cooking
around
class
to help you with this, okay? First, let's prepare our spices. Start by zesting your orange. Next, pour your favorite non-alcoholic apple cider into a medium saucepan. If you don't have cider, unsweetened apple juice works just as well. Then toss in your spices along with the orange zest and set your stove to medium-high. Once it starts to bubble, reduce to medium-low and let it simmer for 15 minutes. When you can smell the aroma of warm spices, take it off the heat and remove your spices with a fine
no,
mesh strainer and leave it to sit for another 10 minutes. Or until just warm enough to handle. Then pour into your favorite heat-safe cup. On its own, this is a drink worth singing praises, but we're going to add a scoop of vanilla ice cream, a dollop of whipped cream, and fresh grated cinnamon, lifting it to new heights.
Ooh, ice
we're
cream
We're using
as well.
Vanilla ice cream, but if you really want to let your Mondstadt spirit
we gotta
soar,
try this.
You're free to use other flavors like cinnamon, pecan, chai spice, or even pandan. Light and creamy, sweet and spiced. This float is a duet of duality.
That's good.
Happy anniversary, Genshin Impact!
What's an anniversary party without some warm, gooey, cheesy goodness? Hey folks, I'm Damon Mills, the voice of Linny.
And I'm Inez Quiñones, the voice of Lynette. Today, we'll be celebrating with a classic, Brie en croûte.
Don't let the fancy name fool you. This dish is surprisingly easy to make.
It looks so cute.
All you need is some brie, store-bought puff pastry, and your favorite fillings.
You gotta remember this,
chat. We'll be using bacon, walnuts, and apricots for ours. The full list of ingredients is right here. After preheating your oven, dice the bacon into small pieces. Then toss it into a pan over medium heat, cooking it until it turns crispy.
Chop the nuts and dried apricots into fine pieces. Then mix them in a bowl with your crisp bacon and resist the urge to eat this stuff by itself.
Next, place your puff pastry onto a baking sheet lined with parchment paper. Cut the brie in half horizontally and place one half of your brie on top with the cut half facing up.
Top the cut brie with your fruity, nutty bacon mix and top with the other half of brie, kind of like a sandwich. If you have any extra, just lay it in a circle around your brie.
Use your beaten egg to coat the pastry. Then
that
fold it
like
up
really
over the top of your
brie
like you're wrapping a present. You want to completely cover the brie with no gaps in the pastry. Twist the top and pinch it shut, removing the excess pastry dough.
Finally, coat the pastry's exterior in your egg wash and bake until golden brown and flaky.
Cheesy, savory, and a little bit sweet, brie en croûte is perfect for sharing. And the best part is that you can fill it with just about anything. Try it with rosemary and figs, caramelized onion and ham, or if you're really daring, sweet chili pepper, green onion, and lochon.
Like a good magician, it's versatile, elegant, deceptively simple, and best enjoyed before it disappears.
Oh, that reminds me. Who's bringing dessert?
Don't worry, I called in some experts.
Welcome back. 在4.1版本啊，除了丰富的剧情和角色啊，还有许多全新的场景区域等待着我们的探索。那么今天啊，我也有幸再次邀请到了我们的场景美术同学阿汤哥来为我们介绍相应的内容。
旅行者们好，很高兴能够再次来到今天的节目现场，我是原神场景美术阿汤哥，今天也会为大家着重介绍一下4.1地区的新场景。
欢迎阿汤哥。上个版本啊，我们已经来到了枫丹，见识到了不同的风土人情，尤其是水下世界的风景啊，给我们带来全新的体验。对于新版本的场景啊，我可是十分期待。那么不妨就从我们身后的这片区域开始吧。从刚才开始，背景中这个漂浮在空中的水体啊，就让我一直十分好奇啊。阿汤哥来给我们介绍一下。
没问题。我们身后的这片区域就是旧枫丹科学院的中央实验室遗址，在自然地形风貌上依旧延续了枫丹的清新优雅，但因为枫丹科学院的某些科技与狠活，使得整个区域发生了巨大的爆炸事故，所以上空有着让人惊奇的异重力凝水体，因失重漂浮在海岸上空几百米，十分壮观。也因为这里曾发生的爆炸事故，场景设计上也是会更加的残破与凄凉。
But you can still go in, right?
的优雅精致，这里更带着一丝淡淡的忧伤。
哎，确实啊，一眼望去啊，都是残破的这个遗迹啊，可以想象啊，当初的这个爆炸事故啊，是有多么惨烈。
是的，相当的惨烈啊。这个场景展现爆炸后的不稳定性是一大难题。我们利用了水道这个不稳定要素去呼应水体，既满足了概念设定，也为玩家创造了进入异重力凝水体的路线。
这个异重力凝水体啊，
我有印象，
在4.1版本的前瞻节目中有提到，好像是可以进去的，对吧？
没错，旅行者们是可以设法进入其中的，而在这些异重力凝水体中隐藏的秘密就等待大家前去探索了。
话说啊，前面你提到这个叫枫丹科学院的机构啊，听上去太疯狂了吧，居然把这么大片区域都给炸掉了。
是的，这些其实都源自于枫丹科学院某次失控的实验。在长久的历史中，枫丹动能工程科学研究院一直在以曾经洗去无数生命，又总有一天会再度遮天蔽日的洪水为敌，寻找着生存的途径。而蕴含着庞大能量能够粉碎大地桎梏的史基矿，则一度被认为是开启救赎大门的钥匙。据此，艾德温·伊斯丁豪斯 生前设计了拥有抵消重力效果的实验性场力发生装置。
What was that?
但最终发生了事故，并未能取得应有的成效。这台实验性场力发生装置也因此失控，停驻在科学院的旧址某处。在旅行者们与它遭遇并陷入苦战时，记得利用它提供的失重效果进行跳跃，从而规避它的招式。
哎，它的攻击方式啊，确实和之前遇到的敌人不太一样，感觉很有意思。看来我们的战斗中啊，要多利用它的机制了。
没错，这不，为了搜索关于枫丹科学院爆炸的各种情报，愚人众也来到了这一带。旅行者在这里将会遇到新的敌人，愚人众双翼人和愚人众风翼人，他们来自隶属于仆人的精锐特务组织，拥有不俗的实力。
They are elite operatives under Arlecchino.
看来这片新区域啊，危险与机遇并存，旅行者们可要小心了哦。那么介绍完地上的区域，这次阿汤哥又给我们带来哪些关于水下的情报呢？
自然是有的。接下来我来再着重讲一下梅洛彼得堡，它与 4.1 的主线剧情十分密切。在枫丹惩治犯人的方法就是将其流放至梅洛彼得堡，这里看似监狱，本质上却被认定为流放者的聚集地，在这可以参加劳作，得到生活的物资。
Oh, they chill here.
整个梅洛彼得堡建设在水下，其隐蔽的结构多以蒸汽管道和齿轮为主，本身略带精致的工业风也衬托着这里是个威严的地方。我们利用多种竖管道结构，并且尝试了多种排列组合，参考了一些常见的蒸汽朋克元素，提炼出属于枫丹水下监狱的艺术特性，想给初次到达这里的旅行者们留下深刻的印象。
的确如你所说，给我留下了深刻的印象。不过作为全枫丹罪人的流放场所，它内部的设施数量想必不止如此吧。
在梅洛彼得堡下方还有一处制造着各种机关的工厂，那里就是流放者们平时劳作的地方了。在继承上方区域的蒸汽管道元素的同时，设计团队围绕着重复劳作和流水线的设计语言，借鉴了多种装置艺术中运用的表达形式，在设计中用重复的环形轨道强调着流水线式的重复感。我们将一部分环形轨道放置于厂房的顶部，
视觉上
巨大的矩阵环形结构也能够给人更强的压迫感。如何让这些精密的齿轮繁而不乱，我们团队也费了不少心思。
能看得出来，虽然是枫丹关押犯人的场所，但我已经等不及去里面探索一番了。
在梅洛彼得堡附近也有不少可以自由探索的区域，这里我向旅行者们介绍一处很隐蔽的水下洞穴。此处被史基矿所影响，产生了奇异的生态景象，旅行者在缠藤中穿梭时会遇到不小的挑战哦。
哎，这非常符合我对水下世界的幻想，各种神秘的区域和奇异的植被啊，总能激发我的探索欲望。不过在这片新的探索区域，想必我们也会遇到一些新的敌人吧。
大伟哥猜的没错，矗立在远海异种顶端的另一位霸主，自泡泡海马成长而来的顶尖掠食者千年珍珠峻灵，就潜藏在这片区域的某个岩窟之中。它进化出了幻兽的形姿，头部下方的异海珍珠更是浓缩了镭元素的结晶，让它能够使用更加猛烈的元素攻击，也拥有更强的防御能力。此外，在探索水下区域时，我们还会遇到执行警戒巡弋任务的新型发条机关，旅行者们也要小心哦。
感谢阿汤哥，
听
完你的讲解啊，让我对新版本更加期待了。一下子看了那么多内容啊，想必大家也有些累了，不如让我们稍作休息。接下来啊，我们还邀请了其他研发组的同学为我们带来更多的内容分享。各位旅行者，不要走开哦。
Okay.No code.
Happy anniversary, Genshin Impact.
I'm Brittany Cox, or as you might know me, der Prinzessin herself, Fischl. With me are my loyal subjects.
Ben Pronsky, voice of Oz, main Fräulein.
And Josie Montana
McCoy. They're going to teach us to make a tart.
Not a subject, but happy to help anyways. Today, we'll be celebrating Genshin's anniversary by making chocolate ganache tarts.
That is a huge recipe.
A royally decadent dish for such an occasion.
In our princessin's benevolence, We've included a list of ingredients here.
First, gather your chocolate cookies in a food processor or plastic bag. Then, crush them like your enemies until naught but the finest crumble remains.
Then mix with sugar and melted butter. Stir until you have a consistency like wet sand.
Firmly press your crumbs into the bottom and sides of a pie tin, then bake in an oven at 350 degrees Fahrenheit or 177 Celsius for 20 minutes or until it's dry and firm.
Once the crust is cooled, coat the interior with a layer of raspberry jam.
For the filling, simply bring your cream to a bare simmer, then pour it over a heat-safe bowl filled with your chocolate, along with a pinch of salt and a half teaspoon of espresso powder.
Let the hot cream stand for about a minute, then stir it all together until you have a ganache as smooth as Kaya himself.
We do, though.
Pour the ganache into your tart shell.
Bro, it's just biscuits and cream. We do get these things.
Arrangement of raspberries.
And for an optional flourish, try this watering down some raspberry jam.
Yeah, it's a no eggs dish.
Or warm water until you have a thin glaze. Then brush it over
your raspberries. You can actually do this.
This will lend your berries an iridescent shimmer. While darkly regal as a certain princessin,
yeah, only
this
raspberries,
tart is also quite flexible. You can substitute raspberry for orange marmalade, bro,
it's just like
citrus,
an anniversary
or
event.
Or mix the jam and top
like,
with hazelnut creamy for a treat
like,
that's
they want to make it
coffee.
Special.
And
yeah.
If you don't want to worry about slicing your tart, substitute the large pan for parchment-lined muffin tins to make perfectly portioned miniature tarts.
Yeah, Twitter is going to... It's already happening in chat, royalty. So... Yeah.
Now, who gets the first slice?
It's just supposed to be cute stuff for the anniversary. Oh, damn. That art, though. Risley does look like Tears of Thames. My god, Risley has like some ear cuff type stuff too. Damn. Bro, his outfit is very nice. I like. That TCG. Oh, no, it's the tournament. It's the tournament. I got scared. They won't. They just have the normal one. They don't have TCG events now. This is like a tournament for their offline events, right? They do a tournament online, like on their special channel, Astro Carnival. They get casters who are streamers usually. And yeah, they get people to compete. We're back to Liyue. In
the 3周年之际, Liyue 也迎来一场盛大的活动。 而我们研发团队中的系统设计师也应邀来到了节目现场, 为我们介绍新版本丰富多彩的活动内容, 来和大家打个招呼吧。
大卫哥和屏幕前的旅行者们, 大家晚上好。 我是系统设计师Helen, 很高兴又和大家见面了。 很荣幸为大家介绍新版本的活动。
She's
very pretty.
听说这次在璃月举办的活动和往年不太一样啊，要不你先来为我们介绍一下？确实有些与众不同。不知道大伟哥还记不记得今年海灯节的那场饭局？当然记得，就是那场胡桃做东，温迪和钟离均有出席啊，甚至连降魔大神萧都在场的饭局吧。
那可真是藏龙卧虎。
没错，这个饭局的许多细节都让人会心一笑，也让温迪和黎月的众人相识。胡桃和温迪还做下了承诺，将来有空一起写诗。这不正巧让他们逮到一个机会，由胡桃与温迪牵头，在石门附近举行了两国合办的诗歌大会，交流诗歌的同时促进两国关系和谐友善发展。
Monster event，
希望在诗歌中让大家感受节日的氛围。
啊，我当时以为他们只是开玩笑而已，没想到他们来真的。不过温迪作为吟游诗人，他的创作水平应该相当高啊，而胡桃的打油诗也独具一格嘛。
不仅仅是他们，还有来自黎月和蒙德的其他伙伴也一起参加了大会，十分热闹。不过在活动期间发生了一件奇异的事，身为参赛者的重云提出自己之前见到了一个类似妖邪的东西，于是众人在参加大会的同时也开始探寻起了事件的真相。
诗歌大会举办的那么隆重，想必与之相关的活动也很丰富吧。
这次我们为旅行者们准备了三个特色活动玩法
，special event，
百步理智、灵感喷击和寻景密画。在百步理智玩法中，旅行者可以投出掷剑，在限定时间内用掷剑尽可能多的命中熔壶，从而获得更高的积分。在挑战的过程中会出现礼环和妙壶，如果投掷的掷剑穿过礼环击中熔壶，即可获得双倍积分。妙壶则可以改变掷剑的投掷频率，帮助旅行者更高效地完成挑战。第二个活动是挑战玩法灵感喷击，在挑战开始后，旅行者打倒敌人可以获得灵感结晶。挑战中有时会出现携带迷思元结的敌人，极为坚韧，难以击倒。灵感结晶每隔一段时间会在角色身边引发一定范围的冲击波，造成巨量伤害。如果能灵活运用灵感结晶的冲击波，或许能轻松打倒这类敌人。寻景密画则是一个通过拍照来寻找缺失景物的玩法，根据提示旅行者需要帮助画作修复师通过拍照修复画作，在拍照时将画片与当前景物对照，寻找画片上缺失的景物，找到后即可将对应景物记录下来并获得奖励。在本次游水运诗集活动中，旅行者们可以参与三个活动挑战，提升诗歌会热度，从而获取专属四星法器无垠蔚蓝之歌及其专属精炼道具等丰富奖励。
这次活动还真是丰富啊，尤其是百步理智活动啊，让我想起了小时候经常玩的这个投壶游戏，这次啊我也可以在游戏中再体验一把了。
是啊，希望这次的活动能让旅行者们感受到诗歌大会欢快的氛围，与蒙德和黎月的大家一起度过令人难忘的时光。说到蒙德，可莉又活跃了起来呢。
怎么，难道可莉又因为炸鱼被秦团长抓了吗？
可莉这次可不是闯祸，反而立功了。她在游玩的过程中偶然发现国舅湖里突然出现了从须弥来的入侵鱼类
invasive fish。
为了维持生态平衡，骑士团需要处理这些入侵物种。在此期间，可莉为了不添乱只能待在蒙德城里。为了不让可莉无聊，丽莎发明了一个有趣的小游戏，在活动嘟嘟可通往集日记中，旅行者们可以陪同可莉一起玩蹦蹦炸弹。通过操作嘟嘟可投出不同类型的蹦蹦炸弹，击败角角鱼大军，书写嘟嘟可打败鱼入侵者的大冒险。
What is this?
火花骑士就像火热的小太阳一样，每次都能给我们带来惊喜呀、啊！这次竟然还发现了入侵物种。
其实有类似困扰的不只是蒙德，在枫丹也有一些本应只存在于实验室内的奇妙生物，突然出现在枫丹的各个水域中。旅行者可以通过极光协彩活动，帮助为此事忙得焦头烂额的商人姬肖恩，通过回收枫丹水下各处的荧光紫水母，消除生态隐患并获取奖励。
保护生态还能欣赏枫丹水下风光，真是一举两得呀。
是的，在枫丹苍鲸区东南侧的水岸处 我们还可以体验到挑战活动人生的波峰与波谷。在这个挑战活动中，旅行者可以帮助
There are many events, right?
测试超高压冲击器，通过合理把握停止增压的时机，提高超高压冲击器释放的超高压冲击波的伤害，来击败敌人。同时，旅行者可以根据出战队伍的角色数量和等级获取载荷。
They're just like a little different.
增益模组，挑战更高难度的敌人。在 4.1 版本中，除了常规的热斗模式更新，七圣召唤的逐境演练也将再次开放。
BCG is back. What do you think the anniversary rewards are gonna be?
获取积分。
It's gonna be the same.
最后，在 4.1 版本，我们还会开启精通遗勇活动。需要培养角色的旅行者们不要错过哦。
I want an anime announcement. Honestly, I'm just looking forward to that.
给我们准备了那么多有趣的活动，看得我都眼花缭乱了，已经迫不及待想去试玩一番了。
另一方面，我们也一直在关注旅行者们的日常游玩状况。随着游戏运营年份增长，一些原本看起来合理的前期和常规设计，如今却成为了旅行者们体验中的痛点。因此，我们在 4.1 版本对前期的内容设计做了部分调整。
Mm-hmm.
首先，我们加强了冒险等阶突破任务的提示，在旅行者们的派蒙界面和冒险手册向导页，都增加了相应的引导。在突破任务中，我们缩短了地城的通关耗时，移除了部分高难度敌人，来帮助新手旅行者更好地完成突破任务。
这个好。其实啊，当初我第一次做突破任务时啊，确实用了挺长的时间。
Well, not that we're talking about his own adventure quest.
不仅如此，我们还对每日委托做了一次重大调整。随着游戏内容逐渐丰富，在每日委托之外，游戏内还有大量玩法等着旅行者体验。因此，我们在 4.1 版本推出了冒险历练系统。在这个系统中，旅行者可以通过完成任务、
Encounter points
获取收集物、参与活动的方式来获取历练点。除了原本的通过完成每日委托获得奖励，旅行者也可以通过累积历练点来换取委托奖励。每天通过两种方式累计最多领取四次委托奖励，每日委托奖励被领取后仍可进行任务。想要体验任务或者完成成就的旅行者可以继续去完成这些委托。历练点将在服务器时间每天的凌晨4点清零。
太棒了，我很早就喜欢有类似的系统呢。当开启新区域或者活动时啊，总感觉要做的事情太多啊，自己时间不够用。那现在有了这个功能啊，我在体验其他内容的同时啊，还能够获得委托奖励。
所以我
们
是
一举两得。
没错，我们也希望旅行者们可以更多的享受游戏中的其他内容，得到多元化的体验。
除了版本活动与系统优化，在公测3周年之际啊，我们依旧为旅行者们准备了一些神秘的奖励。
It's coming, Chad.
庆祝这个特殊的日子。
Our 10 wishes.
也来为大家分享一下情报吧。
Our 10 wishes are coming.
为了感谢旅行者们一直以来的支持与热爱，在 4.1 版本期间，签到活动“观赏流华”将会开启。旅行者们可以通过每日签到，获得最多10枚纠缠之源以及其他道具奖励，不容错过。同时，我们还会通过邮件的形式为旅行者们额外奉上总共1600原石和4个脆弱树枝，以及2个特殊纪念小道具。
Gadget，
便携式空气动力胶质炮生发器和
Bubble Generator。
此外，在 4.1 版本更新后，游戏内商城的首充双倍状态也将会重置。具体信息，旅行者们可以留意官方后续的相关公告。
好耶！相信大家已经和我一样十分期待 4.1 版本的到来了。那介绍完了那么多的活动啊，屏幕前的大家不妨稍作休息，接下来啊还有更多有趣的内容，后面的节目更加精彩。
There's more. They've told us everything, right? This August in Latin America, we joined forces in Mexico's non-profit organization for Subway Stray Dogs. Okay. 1 ton of dog food. Ayo. Doggos got fed. That's cool. Yeah, we can't pet them in game chat, but it's okay. They fed them IRL. This is good though. This is good use of money, honestly. Cute. Okay, more food chat.
Happy anniversary, Genshin Impact. My name is Ben Balmaceda, and as the voice of Kaveh, I'm always looking for better ways to integrate artistic expression and practical functionality. I'm so happy to be celebrating the 3-year anniversary of Genshin Impact. We know fans are celebrating worldwide, but what's a party without decorations? Well, inspired by the enchanting landscapes of Teyvat, here's a fun and functional craft that can really add a mystical vibe to a celebration in a matter of minutes. If you have any mason jars lying around, they can easily be transformed into fantastical yet functional lanterns. All you need is some small battery-powered LED lights, art supplies, and some creative thinking. Decorate the glass with glitter for a nebula jar, or make your own designs inspired by the world of Teyvat with colorful paper, paint, string, or even maple leaves. And place the LED lights, like a battery-powered tea light or fairy light, inside the mason jar. The light will pass through the different shapes and colors to give it a unique and enchanting glow. Yeah, that's looking pretty good. And the fun doesn't stop there. Jenny has another DIY project that can add a lot of color to any Genshin-themed celebration. Ain't that right, Jenny?
Hey, that's right! I'm Jenny Okabori, wishing all the fans and players a very happy 3rd-year anniversary! Well, as the voice of Yoimiya, you know I have a soft spot for colorful, bursting light displays, and we can easily make our own decorations by turning the average balloon into explosive slimes! All you need is a couple of colorful balloons, confetti, and some art supplies. Take your deflated balloon and fill it with either homemade or store-bought confetti. A funnel can really come in handy here. Next, use a balloon pump to inflate the balloon. Regular air allows them to bounce around the room, but if you want a floating enemo slime, you'll need to use helium. Shape the slime into a sphere by letting out a little air.
Doing this with Diwali this year, wow.
Then, go ahead and add some white eyes and any other details you'd like to give the slime a personality. You can use white paint or paper for these eyes. Now, not only do you have some fun slime balloon decorations, but when they pop, they'll explode in a burst of colorful confetti condensate. These balloons and starlight jar decorations can level up any Genshin party as we celebrate this 3-year achievement. I look forward to seeing what you create!
Yep.
欢迎回来! 在今天这个特殊的日子, 能够和屏幕前的旅行者们共同庆祝此刻, 实在是一件值得高兴的事。 从2020年公测至今啊, 相信大家在提瓦特大陆上 也留下了属于自己的独特回忆啊。 这3年以来啊, 不只是各位旅行者, 我们研发团队的同学, 也同样经历了一段宝贵的时光, 想要和大家分享。 坐在我身边的呢, 是大家老朋友Michael。 Michael, 趁着今天这个机会, 不妨为我们讲讲, 项目组内部的故事吧。
感谢大伟哥的邀请, 旅行者们好, 很高兴又与大家见面了。 今天我也很荣幸能代表项目组的同学, 为大家分享内部的故事。 不过由于时间有限, 因此我们简单做了整理，统计了一些有趣的数据给大家带来分享。哦，
这和我之前所想的内容还不太一样。那这些数据背后是不是有什么故事啊？
大伟哥猜对了，每个数字背后啊都有着原神研发团队持续的付出和深厚的感情。接下来就让我们看看第一组数据吧。1000多万啊！
这可是个大数字啊，Michael，这个数字是什么意思啊？
这个数字其实是原神研发以来 我们的 IP 团队在游戏内外创作的叙事文本总字数。
哇哦！
我们游戏中的皮瓦特大陆是一个架空世界，这里汇聚了各种文化、创意、艺术。从零开始构建它的世界观并不容易。原神 IP 创作团队的同学以自身热情与才华，铸就了一个个鲜活生动的角色，编织了一个个扣人心弦的故事，构建了一个宏大精美的世界。细心的旅行者可能会发现，在游戏中处处充满着细节，随意拾取的一本书籍，不经意间获取的武器，副本中掉落的剩余物，他们的背后甚至也有属于自己的精彩故事。其实为了把一个架空世界填满的足够有真实感，光靠游戏内的文本是不够的，在许多内容呈现给旅行者之前， IP 团队就要先行构思几个版本，甚至几年后的概念设定。对于一些要向美术策划海外本地化团队表达的设定，也需要撰写足够细腻详尽的文档以供参考。因此在游戏内所呈现的内容大概也只是浮在创作海洋的一角冰山。
确实啊，这个数字不仅是代表一场游戏的这个制作，更是一次文化的积淀，一次创意的盛宴。
当然海量的文本创作也只是原神内容的其中一个侧写，下面这个数字看起来可小多了，但它也是我们和旅行者一路走来的证明之一呢。
Characters
74，比起第一个数字啊，这个数字是有点小了。哎，不对不对 ，Michael， 你说这是我们跟旅行者一路走来的见证，那它一定是一个随着版本累积下来的数字，对不对？
大伟哥已经快要猜到了。其实啊，这是直到 4.1 版本为止，包括刚才我的同事介绍的大维莱特和莱欧斯利在内，原神已经向旅行者推出了
74。
没想到啊，在不知不觉间啊
，That's a lot of characters。
那么多的这个角色伙伴。不过啊，谈起原神啊，游戏中性格迥异的角色确实被大家津津乐道。
没错，一个引人入胜的开放世界，角色是必不可少的。原神中的每一个角色都有着独特的背景故事和情感世界。通过对话、剧情和任务呈现，旅行者能够更加深刻地了解角色。这种情感共鸣不仅让旅行者与角色建立起情感联系，也为游戏增添了更多层次的情感体验，使整个游戏世界更加丰满和有趣。此外，角色也是构成游戏中战斗体验的重要一环。每个角色都拥有独特的战斗技能和神之眼元素，这不仅丰富了游戏的战斗策略，也为旅行者们提供了更多的选择和挑战。
正因为这些角色伙伴啊，才让皮瓦特大陆的世界增色不少，使得游戏啊不仅仅是简单的战斗和探索，更像是一场情感丰富的冒险之旅。哎，那么让我们看看下一个数据吧。那经历了之前的两个数字啊，我觉得自己是肯定猜不出来的。Michael， 快为我们公布答案吧。
其实这个数字还有一个单位，215G， 它指的是截止 4.1 版本游戏内所有最高精度美术的资源总量。
215G 啊，我大小是有点吓人呐。Michael， 你给我们讲讲背后的故事吧。
可能大多数旅行者不太能判断这个数字所代表的工作量。原神是一个依赖卡通渲染营造幻想氛围的游戏，这就意味着几乎所有的写实类素材，包括照片修改的贴图、真人动捕的动画，都是没有办法直接应用到游戏中的。这 215G 的美术资源是原神的原画师、建模师、动画师、特效师等同学们经过精心构思或实地取材，然后重新亲手制作出来的。
是啊，有的时候我晚上路过我们美术同学的工作区啊，发现有些同学还在工作，还挺过意不去的。但同学们这么辛苦啊，平时还是会非常自豪地给我转发他们最近画的新场景啊、新角色，就像是介绍自己的孩子一样兴奋。
但是啊，大家非常努力创作的同时，也需要考虑到玩家的设备是否能承载这样庞大的资源量。所以我们的技术团队面对如此规模的资源也是付出了相当大的精力，对不同的设备、不同平台进行性能评估和分级，对资源进行不同等级的精度拆分和管理，优化加载和包体构建策略。 其实最近我们看到不少的旅行者留言、
嗯、
觉得枫丹版本的包体占用空间依旧是太大了，对此我们也是深知做得还不够，之后会进一步探索其他的优化手段，给大家带来更好的体验。
They think they will look for a way。
刚才我们看到的是原神游戏内的一些有趣数字，那么接下来这组数字就跟屏幕前的各位有些关系了。
Is this the player base?
哎，这个数字啊，我有些想法。 Michael 啊，你既然提到和屏幕前的大家有关，我猜猜是不是原神全球玩家的关注数呢？
哦，
没错，目前原神全网的关注数已经超过了9953万人了。
We're one of the 99.5 almost 100 million。
虽然猜对了，但是这个数字啊，依旧让我十分惊讶。在当初立项的时候啊，我们可能都没有想到能取得今天这样的成绩啊。有那么多的旅行者走上了提瓦特的大陆，与我们共同创造美好的回忆。
是的，这个数字是旅行者们对我们原神团队的认可，也是最好的回报，同时也督促我们不能懈怠，因为我们承载着旅行者们的期望。话不多说，让我们继续。
这个数字让我看
有点不安，实
在是过于庞大了。我随便猜猜啊，这是不是播放量或者点赞数什么的？
看来大伟哥对这类数据啊特别的敏锐。这是《原神》发布的官方视频内容在全网社区的总播放量，目前已经达到了40亿次。
The video views。
在这些内容创作的过程中，我们同样遇到了非常多的困难。如何更好地把游戏内容通过视频形式展示给大家，并不是一件容易的事情。每当创作同学觉得疲惫或者没有灵感的时候，看看各位旅行者在评论区对内容的支持，就又会充满干劲了。而结果也是如此，只要我们创作出优质的内容，我们就一定会获得回报。
是啊，旅行者们的支持与热爱正是我们创作的动力啊。
接下来让我们分享最后一组数据。不知道屏幕前的旅行者们有没有猜到呢？
11.5 million。
既然已经到了这个环节的最后，我就不卖关子了。开服至今，原神官方每个版本都会举行相关的视频二创活动，这个数字是目前全网参与的总人数，迄今为止已经达到了1150万了。
嗯，有趣的是啊，这个大数字啊一点都不让我意外。
It's a video event。
原神能够取得今天的成果啊，光靠我们研发团队肯定是远远不够的。各位旅行者提供的优质二创内容啊，让原神在游戏之外的地方也散发着自己的光彩，营造了良好的讨论氛围。这份美好
Are they gonna talk about the anime though?
加入到提瓦特的冒险中啊。
是啊，其实这些只是参与了视频二创活动的人数，还有许多其他内容形式的二创作者同样制作了精彩的内容，给大家带来了不少的快乐。虽然未能计入，但依旧感谢你们的支持。
好的，那感谢 Michael 为我们带来的数据啊，也希望以上的数据能让旅行者们对原神项目组的研发团队有更加深入的了解。那在接下来的日子里啊，我也希望可以和旅行者们继续携手前行，共同创造更加精彩的回忆。那么接下来将为大家呈上第三则兑换码，让我们稍后再见。
Oh, it's the Arcanaut. Let's go.Oh my god, the code is gonna go away. Hold on. They look so happy. Look at the cake. Look at the cake with us. Yup, two left. Doesn't feel good.
欢迎大家回到4.1版本的前瞻特别节目。在新版本啊，除了游戏内丰富多彩的内容啊，我们也准备了一些游戏外的内容给大家带来分享。
Okay.
没错，今天我还给大家带来了《原神》的交响音乐会最新情报。 2023年9月到2024年1月期间，我们将在亚洲、美洲、欧洲的11座城市举办音乐会，首站将于9月29日和9月30日在上海梅赛德斯奔驰文化中心举行，欢迎世界各地的旅行者前来体验。同时，音乐会主题的系列周边已经在原神旗舰店等官方店铺开售，有兴趣的旅行者不妨看看哦。
Damn！
哇哦，这些周边看上去好精致啊！我这就回去加入购物车。
其实还有很多音乐会的周边单品。
Dolly wants to add it to shopping cart。
非常让人期待。
OK。
不过在不同地区，因为生产和运力的关系，周边内容的获取方式会略有差异。少数的地区存在延迟或非全品类上架的情况，这还请大家谅解。
大家如果感兴趣的话，可以关注官方社媒账号，了解更多关于音乐会的详细信息。
除此之外，后续游戏内也会上架音乐会礼包侠音异奏，礼包内含有原石、名片、风之翼以及家具摆设。
This is stuff we can buy。
信息，大家也可以关注官方消息。
Michael 啊，自从4.0前瞻节目，
Those are pretty gliders though。
交响音乐的现场就收获了不少好评。许多旅行者都等着枫丹专辑上架呢。
不瞒大伟哥，其实我已经循环了好多遍了，而今天带来的下一则情报正是关于枫丹音乐专辑的。随着旅行者们不断探索枫丹的步伐，我们的枫丹音乐也一直陪伴在大家冒险的旅途之中。 4.1 版本期间，我们将发布枫丹第一张 OST 专辑《白鹿彻鸣之泉》，专辑共有4张分碟，收录了 Hoyo Mix 音乐团队为原神的枫丹地区创作的原声音乐。
手中的红酒杯已经开始摇起来了。
大伟哥，你印象中最深的枫丹音乐是哪一首呢？
印象最深，我最喜欢一首枫丹的战斗音乐啊，每次听的时候都舍不得结束战斗。
我也很喜欢呢。
It's so goofy。
枫丹的战斗音乐展示了枫丹华丽的城邦特色。我们为枫丹音乐专辑也准备了一支华丽的宣传 MV， 一起来看看吧。
Budget chat. Oh my god. Jeez. so generous with the rewards. Yeah, the concert is the anniversary reward. That was very cool.
中间那一小段 flamingo 舞的彩蛋可太对味了。看完这支 MV 啊，我对枫丹专辑更加期待了。
是的，枫丹音乐的制作幕后将会在专辑上架后呈现给各位旅行者。期待 Hoyon Mix 团队的同学能给我们带来更多有关枫丹音乐的创作和设计方面的介绍。
其实我们团队一直都在致力给旅行者们带来更丰富更有趣的体验，无论是线上还是线下啊，都能够感受到提瓦特大陆的美好。那希望我们准备的这些游戏外的衍生内容啊，能给大家带来一些小小的惊喜。
Okay.
Happy anniversary, Genshin Impact! This is Maya Aoki Tuttle reporting. Of course, you might know me as Charlotte, Ace Reporter. And with the upcoming anniversary, I've decided to put my journalistic skills to the test. And what better way than to get the scoop on the voice artists for some of our favorite characters? Therefore, Ace Reporter Maya is on the case. With me are my co-hosts, Damon Mills and Inaris Quinones.
Greetings.
Hey, everybody.
The world of Teyvat sports a diverse cast, so let's hear about what all the talent has to say.
For those that live too long, the friends of days gone by and scenes from their adventures live on in their memories. As such, I have no regrets in meeting you, friend. Should the day ever come that we are not together, you will continue to shine like gold in my memories.Hello, everyone. My name is Keith Silverstein. I voice the Geo Archon Zhongli. Happy anniversary, Genshin Impact. I want to take a second to thank everyone who had a part in bringing Genshin Impact to life. And I mean everyone. No matter how large or small your role in bringing this game to life has been. And that includes the entire Genshin Impact community, which is amazing that I could even just say that. It's a very special thing.When a game comes out and is so popular that an entire community is born alongside it. And so long as it's bringing this much joy to the world, long may it reign.
Hi, I'm Alejandro Saab and I am the voice of Sino in Genshin Impact.
Do you have an anniversary message you'd like to share?
I'd like to thank the Academy. No, in all seriousness. I'm grateful to be a part of this game, and Genshin going on for 3 years, I've been a fan, and this last year, getting to be a part of it was super, like, just super humbling, super, I'm at a loss for words, because Sino was the character when I first saw him in the Teyvat trailer, I was like, dang, I'd really like to play that guy, that'd be so cool, and it happened, and
he manifested it.
It was so cool, and it just makes me really happy again to the opportunity to be this guy. Everybody thinks I've been saying terrible jokes now because of Sino, but that's not true. I started saying terrible jokes because of my partner and my friends around me. I could say one right now.
Hello, I'm Sean Dury and I play Baiju.
Do you have an anniversary message you'd like to share?
Well, happy anniversary to Genshin Impact, and I just want to thank everyone who has been playing the game and enjoying the game.That's really why we make it, so you can have fun playing it. So thank you so much for being a part of it. My favorite Genshin memory of the past year was Baiju becoming a playable character. That was so exciting to go from someone you kind of stopped in and chatted with for a second to someone who is going on a quest and saving the day. So that's absolutely my favorite memory of the past year.
Hey there, my name is Nazit Harsha, and I play Al-Haytham in Genshin Impact.
What is your favorite story from the past year?
The infamous traitor, Azar, anger scene that Al-Haytham has, just because it was really fun seeing the reception to that. And it was very fun recording, you know. It's, Al-Haytham is very reserved, very kind of to himself. So having this one moment where he breaks character...putting on an act, of course, but still, like, showing more emotion than anyone has ever seen him do was very fun to kind of go into. In terms of the game, the thing that I want to say is congratulations for going, you know, 3+ years strong. The world that they've managed to build is nothing short of impressive, and also seeing the sort of fans' admiration toward the game is...you know, nothing short of delightful, really, because there is just such an enthusiasm and such a passion with the fan base. So seeing this sort of relationship between the two is endearing, and the fact that I get to, you know, kind of share in both of these experiences is awesome.
Hey, what's up? I'm Zach Gordon. I am the voice of Tainari. If I have one anniversary message, it's I can't wait till the next year and the year after that, and I hope to be around for as long as we all enjoy the game. So thank you.
What is something you like or admire about your character?
One thing that, if I may say so myself, I feel like we worked really hard to do well was his ability to care about Kale. And I think that a lot of people that really know what they believe in and feel that they're very intelligent, quote unquote, I think sometimes the ego can get in the way of that. And one thing that I really admire about Tainari is that he's able to put that aside and really focus on what matters, which is being able to articulate and translate what he knows and pass it on to a student or an apprentice, somebody like Kale. And so I think, to sum it all up, compassion. I think Tainari is a very compassionate individual. We certainly tried our best to infuse that into the role.
My name is Ben Balmaceda. I voice Kaveh.
Do you have an anniversary message you'd like to share?
After seeing Genshin when it first came out, I had no doubt that it was going to be something special and it was going to stand the test of time. There's so much potential to be had in Teyvat, and like so many new people to meet and places to explore and travel to. The game's just a gem, and like, as far as people that have helped me get this far, like, I just want to thank all my friends that are part of the cast, all the Sumeru, Krumeru, and also to all the fans. Like, they've been so
Sumeru,
lovely
Krumeru.
And welcoming, and it's such a lovely community. It's just been a wonderful journey, and I hope that it continues far past the horizon.
What's up? My name is Patrick Pedraza. I'm the voice of Scaramouche, the Balladeer, Wanderer, Hat Guy, a man of many names. Well, 3 years, man, that's a long time. I have no idea what the future's gonna bring for the game, for me, but I'm just, like, I don't want to sound cliche, but I'm really super grateful to be part of this.
What is your favorite story from the past year?
Oh, my favorite scene, oh gosh, there's so many. It's like the boss battle. When I first saw the boss battle when I was doing the session, I was like, this is gonna be insane. And the boss battle theme, oh my gosh, that was just like insane. But then I was like, oh my gosh, I saw the end, and then Scaramouche just goes straight on his head, looking right at you, poof. Yeah, that was kind of sad, but it was kind of, that was my favorite one.
Hi, I'm Anyatko. I voice Raiden Shogun, and A, and Makoto, and a handful of NPCs. I can't believe that Genshin Impact has been going on strong for 3 years, and we've got plenty more to go. I'm so excited for what the future holds for Teyvat. I am just starting to explore Fontaine and getting through the Fontaine Archon quest, and it is so, so much fun so far. And I just really want to thank the fans, all of the travelers who have been on this journey with us for the past 3 years. None of this would mean anything without you guys. So thank you for playing. Thank you for loving this game.
What's one of your favorite character lines?
Okay, I get asked this a lot, and the answer is the about Ito line.
Who?
I just think it's so funny how in one word you get to know exactly what Raiden Shogun thinks of the one and only Arataki Ito. That never fails to make me laugh.
Hi, my name is Kimberly Ann Campbell, and I'm the voice of Nahida, the Dendro Archon in Genshin Impact.
What was your favorite memory of the past year?
Okay, so there are a lot, and no surprise, there are a lot to do with Nahida. But I would say that one of my favorite memories from last year would have to be when Nahida's trailer dropped. She has two trailers, but the one in particular that comes to mind is the one where she's going through her birthday over and over again, and it starts off as happy, and then it's like, oh, okay, it's still kind of happy, but then it gets really dark and, like, really depressing. And even though it's, like, a really sad video, it was, like, super well done, and I was like, oh my gosh, this is so good. And like seeing everybody's reactions to it, like I've watched like a ton of reactions from like streamers, YouTubers. It was like just amazing to see everybody's reaction to it. I could not wait for it to come out. I'm glad it turned out as well as it did.
Well, there you have it, folks. Straight from the mouths of some of our favorite characters, it's
Isn't there someone you've forgotten?
Two someones, to be exact.
I was totally about to get to you guys. I swear.
Right. That's what I thought.
Can you give us a short intro?
My name is Damon Mills, and I voice Linny, the greatest magician in all Teyvat.
Is there anything you want to say to the community about your character?
I think Linny and Lynette's story is quite fascinating because they're both
incredibly
fun characters.
His voice is so deep.
And all about razzle dazzle, but their collective past is so dark and painful. I mean, they both mask it really well, particularly Linny, who appears front-facing very confident, but he's burdened by his ties to the Fatui, growing up as an orphan, kind of acting as a parent to his siblings. I feel like he was forced to grow up really fast, and I guess I can relate to that.
Do you have an anniversary message you'd like to share?
I still remember when Genshin first came around, and I thought it was the neatest concept. I know this game has gotten so many people through so much stuff, and I'm really excited to finally be a part of it in such a big way. It's really special to me, and I can't wait to see where the rest of the game goes.
My name is Anais Quinones, and I am the voice of Lynette, and I actually adore cats, so this is a true honor.
Is there anything you want to say to the community about your character?
Yeah, Lynette is really fun for me because, you know, she is the deadpan kind of, I guess, emotionless character archetype, but we did try to elevate her from that. So it's really fun trying to, you know, keep that feel, that base feel of her being deadpan, but also adding enough nuance so that she is an interesting character.
Do you have an anniversary message you'd like to share?
Yeah, 3 years, that's crazy. I'm very excited. I'm excited to see future characters. I'm excited to see more Fontaine, and more Lynette, of course. And I wanna thank you guys for being so supportive and stuff. It's been a blast, and I can't wait to see you guys. Enjoy the rest of it.
There you have it, folks. For real this time. This is Ace Reporter Maya signing off.
到这里，四点一的前瞻节目也接近尾声了。在这充满激情和期待的时刻，我首先想代表项目组的同学们，向各位旅行者表达最真挚的谢意。
No anime news。
感谢你们一直以来对原神的支持与厚爱。从原神上线至今，正是有了你们的陪伴与热情，我们才能不断前行。回顾一路走过来的时光，旅行者们向我们提出了许多宝贵的反馈与建议，我们也因此能不断优化游戏体验，推出更多高质量的游戏内容，让大家能够在游戏中体验到更多的乐趣。在未来的日子里，我们将继续坚持这一理念，无论是新的角色、新的剧情，还是新的玩法，我们都将以更加饱满的热情为大家带来更多惊喜与挑战。最后再次感谢各位旅行者的支持与鼓励，让我们在 4.1 版本不见不散。
Already ended. Yep, no anime news. No, it's done. Yep, see? We're offline now. Yeah, they just said till 7, I guess not. They fooled us, chat. Yep, it was amazing though, yeah. I'm a little salty about the anime. Can we watch trailer again? Do you think they've put it out? I also want to watch the trailer again, not gonna lie. Oh, I actually found someone else's version of it. I mean, this is not the official thing, but it's okay. We'll watch it. Hold on. I do want to watch the trailer again because it's pretty interesting. No, wait a second. That's the wrong link. Excuse me. That was like my Kafka stuff. Okay.
The fortress of Meripede may seem like a prison, but it should in fact be regarded as a gathering place for exiles. I will arrange false charges against you so that you may secretly investigate inside the fortress.
The truth is, this place has a lot of hidden rules.
All of our informants, including the ones that had infiltrated the guards, suddenly vanished.
That's Linny, right?
Something bad will happen during lunch on the third day.
A mysterious box? A bottle of crimson liquid?
So, you know those pipes that make strange sounds? Don't ever, ever go near them at night.
Sooner or later, all will pay the price for their arrogance.
Crimson liquid?
This could get a little chilly. Time's up. Negotiations have broken down. Please leave, ladies and gentlemen.
If Risley does have a plan, Risley. What could it be?
After being away from the sunlight for so long, even the terrifying depths of the sea start to feel like home.
I have to...
Have we entered into the next stage of the prophecy?
Is that Arlecchino? I feel like
and
it
now,
is.
Another catastrophe will soon be upon us. I mourn this turn of events.
Oh, the music!
I find it difficult to express my emotions because I cannot fully understand myself.
I'm confident that we'll find the meaning of our existence one day.
Rumors saying that you were born from calamity. You inherently bring danger to those around you.
Why should we trust this species from who knows where anyway?
Melazines can't be trusted! That goes for Nervalette too!
There's only one thought on my mind. Only through bloodshed can the debt be repaid.
Where did you take my siblings?
Even if the truth may not be pleasant,
since they have no way to dispose of the leftover remains, they have ways to transform them into other forms and keep them in the fortress forever.
It beggars belief just how carefree you have been. From the very beginning, you, the god Fossilor, have failed to take action.
Who is that?
Who are you? What are you trying to do? Please,
don't when
me.
I saw Articuno's shoe here, though. When I saw the trailer for myself, it look at Arlecchino's shoe.
Just how carefree you have been. From the very beginning, you, the god Fossilor, have failed to take action.
Who are you? What are you trying
Do you see that? The one begging is Farina. Yeah, the one yelling, I think, is Arlecchino. But there's another voice that shows up later. Don't tell me it's the sustainer. No way.
I need you. Please, don't kill me. I'm begging you.
Is this what justice means to you? Answer me, Nubilat.
That's some NPC.
You will see much in the human world, from the delightful to the depressing. And one day, when you have dwelt among humanity long enough, you will be placed to bring judgment over
this is
all
gold.
As a
exactly.
For Fontaine's past.
Or the previous Archon.
It is unnecessary to hold me in such high regard.